So, as far as comic books goes, again, I broke down this into two sets of comic books categories. The first one is five comic book series that I finished, like I've read every issue, right? And the second category is 10 comic book series that I plan on finishing. So I haven't even touched on some of my individual standalone comic books or some of the minis would be. These are long comic book series, volumes, I guess you can call them. Okay, so five comic book series that I finished that I think they're absolutely brilliant. The first one would be Transmetropolitan by Warren Ellis and Derek Robertson. That came out, it ran from 1997 to 2002, 60 issues. Absolutely fantastic by Vertigo, by DC Comics. Okay, well worth the read. The second series, comic book series that I finished, that I think was one of the most, the best comic book series I've ever read in my life, was the 2012 Archer and Armstrong series by Fred Van Lent and Clayton Henry. It ran for 25 issues plus issue number zero, and it's from Valiant Comics, and it went from it ran from 2012 to 2014. Super fun. Now, I mentioned this before in one of the first videos I ever created for the Language of Mathematics, which was five book recommendations, and I recommended this as well as a break from all the science and the mathematics, which is Bone by Jeff Smith. And he originally self-published this with Cartoon Books and then went to Image, and it ran for 55 issues from 1991 to 2004. And it's all compiled together in one thick book that you can grab and read. Fantastic read. And I've read that, I don't know, at least two, I think three times now. The second comic book, it's not comic books, but comic book strips that I've read all of multiple times, is Calvin and Hobbes by Bill Watterson. It's basically a cartoon strip, syndicated cartoon strip that ran from 1985 to 1995. And, you know, they come in volumes, and there's the Sunday specials and the strips and strips with the Sunday special. Absolutely fantastic, right? And the fifth animated series and the comic book series that I've read is a manga, which is called Akira. By Katsuhiro Otomo from 1992, and it was adapted into English in 1998. Fantastic manga, fantastic comic book. Reveals, like, I read the manga, the comic book, way later after watching Akira multiple times, and after watching the animation, the movie, after you've read the comic book, you're like, wow, like, there's maybe a 10 second segment in the animation that's, you know, a whole volume in the manga, right? Multiple issues. So if you like the animation, the movie, you should definitely read the manga. It's fantastic, right? So those are five comic book series that I've read that are absolutely magnificent. And here is 10 comic book series that I plan on finishing, that I've read. With only one of these, I've only read a little bit, but for most of them, I've read a fair bit. I just haven't finished because there's so much of it, right? The first one is Hellblazer, various artists, various writers. It ran for 300 issues from 1988 to 2013, and it's brilliant. It's one of my all-time favorite comic book series. The Walking Dead by Kirkman, Tony Moore, and Charlie Adlard. It started in 2003 and it ran for 155, well, it's at 155 issues and I've only read 68. And I started reading this because of a comment that was posted on the first video that I put out, giving comic book recommendations, where I recommended Bone by Jeff Smith. And someone, I believe they posted a comment that just sent me a message, personal message, saying, you know, I should be reading The Walking Dead. So I tracked down The Walking Dead, and it was a period where I wasn't reading too many comic books. And I started reading it, and within a week and a half, I read, like, it took me about 4 days to read 10 issues. And then I read the rest of it, which was like 58 issues, in a matter of a week. I was staying up until the middle of the night reading Walking Dead. The cliffhangers for Walking Dead are amazing. You know, I will definitely finish off the series 100%. I'm just waiting to do another binge read on it. Preacher by Garth Ennis. I haven't finished it. It ran for 66 issues, so I don't even know which parts I've read. I think I've read, I'm pretty sure I read the beginning. I'm not 100% sure anymore because I read a long time ago. Savage Sword of Conan. I've read a ton of it. I haven't read all of it. Okay. And it's got 235 issues in it. And I've read probably 100, maybe. Looking forward to reading the whole thing. It's my favorite comic book series of all time, really, for any genre. This and Hellblazer, top two. And it's got multiple artists. Roy Thompson was a main writer for a lot of them. And the artists, some of the ones that I've read that I've loved a lot, Ernie Chan, Dick Giordano, Barry Windsor Smith, obviously, Boshima, and Pablo Marcos. Those are some of the ones that I've really liked a lot. Okay. And one thing I found out after just digging down some of this info for it, because Savage Sword of Conan was not comic book format, it was magazine format, it didn't have to abide by the comic book code. So that's why, I didn't know this, that's why it was a little, always felt more intense than the rest of the stuff I was reading. Okay. I plan on reading Saga by Brian Vaughan and Fiona Staples. I haven't even read a full comic yet. I've read pages from different issues, right? And I've heard it's amazing, and a lot of people I've talked to that I respect their opinions, they're asking me why I'm not reading it. It's because I didn't get on it right away. And I have a lot on my table right now that I'm reading, and at some point I'm going to just sit down and do a Walking Dead on it and just binge read, you know, 60 issues or something. I think it's at 35 issues right now. Another series that I plan on reading, finishing, and I've only read, I think, like I've read more than that. I start picking these up at the library. I've read probably 6 or 7 volumes on this, which is Lone Wolf and Cub. By Kazuo Koki and Gosuke Kojima. And the dates on this, I didn't realize it was this. From 1970 to 1976, that's when the series, these comics were put out. I didn't know this when I was reading it. I thought Lone Wolf and Cub was still being put out. I guess the stuff that Dark Horse was doing was reprints or maybe some news stories. I don't know. I gotta look into it more. But fantastic. What I read was absolutely amazing. Another series that I've so close to finishing, but I didn't finish it. So because this one, actually, I was reading it from the library as well. I was going to my library. So DMZ by Brian Wood and Ricardo Borcilli. It ran from 2005 to 2012, 75 issues, 72 issues, and I've read a fair bit of it. I haven't finished it. Another one that I haven't finished, Sandman by Neil Gaiman. Not sure why I never finished that. You go through periods, right? It ran from 1989 to 1996, and I don't think I've read the last third. Ran for 75 issues. And I'll have to read from the beginning again. Sandman was pretty intricate, so I'll definitely be reading it as a binge read at some point, doing a marathon on it. 100 Bullets by Brian Azzarello. And Brian Azzarello is one of my favorite writers. I try to pick up a lot from him. He's definitely one of my favorite writers for the stuff he did on Hellblazer. And right now he's doing American Monster for Aftershock, which is fantastic. So 100 Bullets by Brian Azzarello. And what do you call that? American Monster is very reminiscent of 100 Bullets. And I ran for 100 issues, and I haven't read all of it. I've read maybe, I think, less than a half. And I've read a lot of Why the Last Man by Brian Vaughan and Pia Gura. And it ran from 2002 to 2008. I've read a fair bit of it, but I haven't finished it. And I definitely want to finish it. It was a fun read. Okay.